You how to use the drawing tool in DIY task to do a wiring diagram exercise. So the first thing we need to do is go over here to the modules tab, and we're going to go to default by subject, and we're going to pick a folder we're going to put this in. So I'm going to do something on wiring diagrams, I'm going to put it inside here, electrical theory, and we click the little plus. Now by default, lesson is going to be shown here, but we can't do the drawing tool in a lesson. It has to be in a task. That's where the drawing tool is. So change to make sure that's type is task, and then we're going to title it and click add. If you want to put a little icon here that would greet the students, there is a place you can put images here for icons. I got a number of icons uploaded here. I'll just put the Electude E there. Looks good. Now we're going to edit the module. So we've got a kind of a blank slate here. Think of this as kind of like an artist canvas. And we can put some basic instructions up here in this page area. This plus button here would add pages to this activity. This bottom plus would add questions to this activity. I'm just going to call this wiring. And then you could put, you could put a legend here if you wanted to, like red. No, it's not switching around at all times. And then blue or purple. Varying voltage. Okay. So then we're going to type here study. Just an example, and then we could add a couple more questions here. We could do the same, use but you get the idea. You could add as many questions here to use up all these colors. Now I'll go back here to question one. Now we got to get an image in here so that the student can draw over it. So we're in the creation mode. We're in here as a teacher. So first thing you need to do is make sure that you have the image inside Electude that you want to use. So you go over here to the photographs. And if you haven't used this feature yet, you'll only have just one image folder. But those are going to get real, that page is going to get really full after a bit. So I recommend adding subfolders to images, and you can do that just by right clicking on this folder. If I do it just right click on that folder, and you can, there we go, and you can add new subfolders. So if I wanted to add one here for suspension or engines, I can do that. So it's just a nice way to keep your your pictures organized. Now I've already got some images here, wiring diagrams. If I didn't have the wiring diagram I wanted to use here, I would just upload, and you'd upload an image from your photos, like a screenshot of a wiring diagram or something like that. I'm going to use this one here, which is a high-low cooling fan control on a, I think it's a 2000 Corvette. It's kind of a neat circuit because when this relay is turned on, these motors are connected in series, and then when all three relays are turned on, each motor gets their own ground path here. So I guess I better put some more instructions here. Study wiring, use red. Yeah, I guess that one's okay. But when we get to starting to do switch power and stuff, you'd have to tell the student if it was either when in low or high. Now what would so we got this got the oh I got the image in there. I didn't mean to put the photo in there. We can't draw on it yet, so I kind of screwed up here. I didn't mean to put that photo in there. Instead of starting this video over, I'm just gonna we're gonna paste over this. I should have clicked here. So yeah, you need to make sure that your image is in there. That's step one. But I didn't need to insert it yet, so that was the mistake I did. I can't draw over this. We got to go to this little drawing tool, and then we click the plus to make a drawing. We're going to make a new drawing, and we're just going to call this wiring diagram. And then we select a background. This is where what I should have done. So we select that background image. There it is. And we hit save. Hit save and then okay. Now we see this this wording here, wiring diagram cooling fan. That tells me that this is a drawing exercise with a background image. That was that picture. So that's kind of how you do it. And then you would just go in here and you'd add your questions. Here again, you grab the wiring diagram. If you wanted that image to carry through, that's probably what we want to do. I probably should have, because this would be, we want to use the same one. Hit OK. There we go. And now let's go see what this would hit save. Make sure you hit save. And now we're going to close this out, publish this thing. Assign it to my students. There we go. Assign it to my students. There it is. Now I'm going to log in as a student. Let's take a look there. There it is. Wiring diagram exercise. Start module. Okay, study wiregram, use a red color pencil, trace the power at all times. So they click to draw here. And they'll probably want to make this image a little bigger so you can do that. And then they can move it around here on the screen a little bit. Oops. Oh, whoa. Made that too small. There we go. There's my bar I was looking for. Okay. All right, so now we're going to grab our pencil. So here's our pencil color down here. Right now it's black. You can change the weight of the pencil down here. I'm just going to put it to 5. We pick our squiggly little line, and then we're going to change this color from black to red. And now we're going to trace the hot at all time wires. So we'll start here. Go down like that. Now this has got this box around it. You have to kind of click off of that and not wait till that gets done. Trying to get it off. Sometimes this takes a bit for it to get off of that. And you just have to, there we go. Click on the squiggly line again. And we'll do this power wire. I'm not sure why this takes so long. I don't know if it's saving or what it's doing. Probably saving. But it's takes a little bit for that box to go away so I can draw a new line. That's the only aggravating part of this. So I'm just kind of clicking in this open area to try to get this box off. Don't know if it's my internet connection or what it is, but it seems like it's slow here today. Come on. get started drawing. There we go. I don't know what was going on there. Oh, maybe I don't have to wait for that. Let's see here. Maybe I'll just... There we go. Maybe I don't have to wait for that. I was thinking maybe I had to wait on that. All right, so if I close this out, and that there it'll be. Now, if I go to this next one, there, now use the green color trace ground at all times. So go open this again, and we'll zoom up on that, and we'll click our little green thing, and we'll select our green color, hit OK. Now we got a green wire, so we got a little guy there that's green. Oh. Make mine a little wider there. 5. There we go. That little guy is green. Yeah, you don't have to wait on that. I was thinking you had to wait on that box. That's good. So I was creating a problem for myself that I didn't need to worry about. There's green wire. Here's another one. Yeah, this works pretty slick, I guess. So, any other green wire ground at all times? I think that's it. Yep, that's it. All right. And then if we want to have the student trace switch to power on low, if that was another question, you know, the student would just change their color of their crayon, change that to orange, hit OK. We already got the squiggly line turned on, so this would be switched to power here. And actually, that's going to go all the way up here. This relay is off, so it's normally closed. And there we go. Looks like this color got changed here. I'm going to switch that back to green. It was probably highlighted when I changed colors to orange. There we go. There we go. So there's my wiring diagram. I'll close this guy out. Isn't that slick? I think it's kind of a fun activity. Once you get kind of used to it, there before I was waiting on the boxes, but you don't have to wait on the boxes, so but kind of a neat activity, and we might even have to build a task like this on Electude. I think it's kind of a neat little tool once you get used to it.